The commonly sung nursery rhyme, Ring a Ring of Roses, actually recounts the effects of the Great Plague of London in 1665. The Ring of Roses describes the red rash that would arise on the skin at the onset of the illness, while the onomatopoeia refers to the sneezing fit that directly preceded death. The Great Plague devastated London, killing approximately 20% of its population. Only during the Great Fire of 1666 was the plague eradicated. This simultaneity likely resulted from the fire's destruction of the environment that cultivated the spread of the plague. Close living quarters and lack of sanitation accelerated this pandemic by facilitating the forms of disease transmission. The plague is caused by the bacteria Yersinia pestis. Why pestis first infects rodents, which the streets of London provided plenty of in the form of sewage rats. These rats are then bitten by fleas that ingest why pestis. When the infected flea then bites a human, it regurgitates the bacteria into the individual. Though many of the organisms are successfully phagocytosed, digested and killed by certain cells in the body, the macrophages are unable to perform this function. In fact, why pestis has evolved to kill the macrophages. This results in a key breakdown in the body's immune response. Macrophages serve the immune system as antigen-presenting cells. Their role is to break down the bacteria and present the protein used to identify the foreign invaders to the helper T cells. With the macrophages out of commission, why pestis wreaks havoc on the body, while the immune system remains paralyzed by this break in the chain of antibody production. Upon the death of the macrophage, the bacteria is released into the extracellular region, allowing for their rapid spread to the lymph nodes. From the lymph nodes, why pestis makes its way into the bloodstream, where it goes to affect the body's major organisms, including the liver and the lungs. This pathway the illness takes is referred to as the bubonic plague. Though rampant and fatal, it does not represent the most dangerous form of the plague. Once why pestis infests the lungs, it becomes an airborne disease, transmitted when the infected person coughs or sneezes. When a person becomes infected via this form of transmission, it is called pneumonic plague because it travels directly to the lungs. Because the pathway proceeding from the bloodstream to the lungs is avoided, the effects of pneumonic plague occur much more rapidly, making it almost always fatal. This latter form of the plague makes it a potentially powerful weapon in a bioterror attack. Though why pestis can be treated with antibiotics, efficiency would be vital. However, the speed with which it would spread were it to be released in aerosol form would likely make it hard for the antibiotics to keep up. Therefore, the best protection would be in the form of a vaccine. Sure enough, a vaccine offering adequate protection is in the works. However, until this vaccine is marketed, the irony will persist that the advances in technology used to eradicate the plague might also enable it to become an even greater threat to a targeted population.